Good morning, everyone. Welcome to another exciting episode of DDOwiki stream with your host. So DDOwiki talk with T13. I'm ShoeMaker on Ganeth mostly. Hey, so we're getting some people this morning. Looks like we should get the list up and start putting names in. All right, what do we got here? Let's make our background picture go away. Let's see here. A little bit of resizing. What do we got? All right, so we got 500 turbine points. We need 10 people today. All right, what do we got? We've got ZEZ INHOLOKAO. We've got Titan. I told you next week I will lift the non-moderator restriction, but this week, yeah, just have to get through it. So we got Vermgil, we've got Pub of his presence. We've got XM1762. Full host 77. Mummy killers. Poker mage. Xander, Sweat. Oh, who do we got? Anything else? Have I missed anybody? I think that's everybody. Yes. I actually got onto two servers this morning, Caneth and Kyber, and put up an LFM advertising that the stream would be up this morning. We've already got our 10 members first thing before we even got started. That's awesome. So, yeah, a little bit of buffering there on the video sometimes. And there's a little bit of a delay between when I say something and when you see it. And then that makes a delay in when you respond to what I say, which means that when you say something in chat, sometimes it'll take me a minute or two before I get it and you hear the response. All right, let's see here. So we got Amref showing up. I never roll a one. Watch this week, Xander. I'll roll a one, and you'll be like, man. Oh, all right. So we got S-U-D, Zan, Mel. I do. I have even more. Bad karma. All right, so do we have anybody else showing up this morning? This is going to be a big list of people. Looks like I misspelled Vermagil, but I'm not going to go back to fix it. I'll know who it is. All 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. I see 14 there. Subzimel. Or infohost. Don't forget that myself and Titan don't, my posting on LFM. What makes you think it's a violation of TOS? Considering that it's a Turbine-specific stream hosted by Turbine itself. I'm just the host. Alright, so I'll go through at the end and make sure I got everybody. But I think that's everybody so far. Oh, there we go. One more to add in there. How to win. MISSSAINS. You're already entered. All you have to do is at the end of the stream, be the lucky one that when I click on the roll for winner button, shows up as the winner on the screen. That's it. That's all you got to do to win. You're already entered. So back before we started, when it was just Titan in here and myself, Titan suggested that we do epic damage resistance on the physical resistance rating needs a page for itself. So that's a spin-out article that he's talking about. So if we go to physical resistance rating, all right, so yeah, it's kind of a long page, I suppose. Epic damage resistance. So is that what you're talking about, Titan? The fact that it's a red link? Oh, I'll also mention that this will be the last stream that I will mention Movember. Yes, page does not exist. Okay, so you're talking about the fact that it's a red link. Do you have any information on epic damage resistance? I don't think it's anything special, is it? Any more than regular damage resistance, other than it's red, it's typed for epic, right? So if we go to the damage resistance page, we don't have a damage resistance page. If I go to DR, where does it take me? Damage reduction, okay. So let's see here. Control find epic. Epic Destinies, Monk's Gain, DR10, Epic. Alright, so let's see here. So what we're going to do, right, is we're going to go here and we're going to edit the feats. It's not an epic feat, really. It might be. Epic damage reduction. Okay, so we'll take a look at that, I guess. Epic damage reduction. There is no such page. So, let's search for other articles. Now there's an icon for it. So if I click on the icon, it probably is epic damage type. It's used on epic feats. So if we go to epic feats, I also want to take a look at epic damage type. There it is. General epic passive feats. So I'm gonna copy this and I'm gonna scroll down and epic. Shouldn't be any spaces in bulleted lists like that. I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna go like that, make a pipe link. Epic damage reduction, pipe link, save. I'm going to go to epic damage type here. Look at this. Tells a little bit about it, I suppose. That might be a better link location. So we're going to actually edit it again, and we're going to change the location in the pipe link. So we're going to have it go to epic damage type instead for this one. And then epic damage reduction page itself should be a redirect to the section for the feat, or should it? It should. Good morning, Crazy Clown. Go 45. All right, got you guys added. We're having so many people this week that I might even raise the number of required people to 25 next week. Three barrel map cove still shows the Minotaur as being a rare. Yes, what Titan said. Talk in chat. Be a contributor. Yep, I already got you, Miss Sains. Ah, so we got Alright, so we're done with that. We're done with that. Recent changes. Three Barrel Cove map. Oh, I see Titans working with me here. Cloak of Invisibility. Let's take a look at that real quick. We'll head to Three Barrel Cove map in just a minute. Actually, let me make this light behind me go away so it's easier to see me. This is DDO Wiki Talk with Technical 13. So let's see here. We got that drops in Tempest Spine. Invisibility. Yeah, not bad for level 9. I'd probably slot Feather Falling in there myself. But let's see here. So you're only tagging them as Lamania because Lamania removes all the other categorizations. Um, All right, so there's some things in the Lamania. Nope. Zizen, I actually don't go. I'm not a in-game stream. I am a editing the wiki stream. It's like tutorials and working with the community to improve things that they feel intimidated by the wiki to improve themselves. Although there's really no reason to feel intimidated, because you can go in and you can make edits, and as long as you're doing it in good faith and attempting to make an improvement, then even if something goes wrong and it's not working like it's supposed to, send an administrator or somebody else that has lots of edits a message on their page or get in touch with them some other way, and they can go in and fix it real easy. So don't worry about breaking the wiki. You really can't. The only one that can break the wiki really is me. So, yep. Yeah, you're only a VIP for now, Titan. Keep editing. You'll get promoted as you go through. All right, so the test dojo and the test dojo loot room are things that are always going to be in the Lamania category. So what we should do is edit, scroll down. They have the Lamania tag, which puts them in the category. We open up the Lamania template in a new page, and I'm not forgetting about Three Barrel Cove. The cat's name in the background. Her name is Mary Jane, and she is mad at me because I haven't fed her yet this morning. So now she's sitting in the middle of the floor with her butt facing towards me, giving me attitude. Yeah, you. She has an incredible sense of humor. So what do we got here? Where's our categorization for adding it to the Lamania category? Category Lamania. All right, so do we have any? What I'm going to do is see if I can remember how to do this. Sort full page name, just page name. I don't want full page name. Yes, feed me, human. I might actually have to get up and feed her, because she won't stop until I do. So we have sort page name in there. Actually, that's a pretty well put together template as far as that goes. Successfully move a page. Yes, I can probably do that. So we have this in there, add ability to sort. Now I should be able to add a sort equals star, because they will always be in that category. Sort equals star, Sort equals star, save, save. And now when we go back here and we refresh the page, these two should be up here. And they are. Pause for a cause. Okay. A bunch of jokers in here this morning. Lamania release notes. That will always be Lamania. That will always be Lamania. Anything else here that will always be Lamania? Now, actually, Lamania testing, yeah, I don't know. Test Dojo we're done with. Test Dojo Loot Room we're done with. We're done with the template. Edit. Edit. Exactly, Vemgil. Let's see here. And Titan wants to move a page. So if we go to recent changes, okay. And we go to Titan's page. So we got user talk Titan. If we go to Titan's user page, right? So we're gonna edit. We're gonna do this right on Titan's page. Epic wand bracelet doesn't exist. What makes you think that? See how it's a dark color red instead of a light colored red? And when you mouse over it, it's got this little S thing at the end that shows up. That means that it's a stub. It means it does exist. It's just a really, really short page, which means it's just a screenshot. So if somebody was to take it and do... named... jewelry and do, well, we'll get back to that. Let's do this, get some of these other pages taken care of. Oh, I hate it when it does that. Paste, paste. Titan page. So we can trim all this out, blank the page. And we're going to add a little bit of this stuff here. So we're going to put in, feel free to change the formatting later, Titan. This is for demonstration purposes. All right, so we do this, merge information. We're going to delete Titan's page. Okay. All right, so text is hard to see here. Let's blow this up a little bit here. Let's go to Titan's page. I gotta be ShoeMaker in order to delete pages, so I'm gonna go in and I'm gonna delete the page. Author request. I don't go. All right, I'll watch it. Delete the page. Okay, so that page no longer exists. So if we go here, it'll tell me that it's been deleted. It doesn't exist. Okay, excellent. So refresh the page here. It'll say this page has been deleted by Technical 13, blah, blah, blah. So now pay close attention here, Titan. to move a page. You go up to the little drop down, you select move. You select the destination of where you want it to go to. I want to move the stuff that's on your talk page to your user page. Give it a reason. And no, I can't spell. So I love my spell checker. All you have to do is click on Move Page once you do that. And it'll tell you User Talk Titan 2014-19 has been moved to User Titan 2014-19. And it'll also tell you that a redirect has been created. There's no way for you to avoid creating the redirect. So if you go to open that in a new page, so you go to, and there it is, it's been moved. And if you go to User Talk, it's got a redirect here. But we don't want to redirect there because we want your talk page to be open for the ability to talk. So we're just going to blank the page. Actually, I got that little bit of code there, show preview, which will expand into that big chunk of code. Only one winner per week, that is correct. I don't have as many codes as Cordovan does, so I'm not able to give out 10, 15 codes a week. He gives me like 5 codes a month, so I have to stretch them out over the course of a month. So it's one winner per week. Yeah, I lifted that restriction last week upon special request for Titan, and then Titan didn't show up. So I'm like, oh, really, Titan? Really? So yeah, there's your user welcome, Titan. Welcome to the wiki. Nope, you are not a moderator. You can tell moderators because of the green box with a sword in it. You might win 500 turbine points. All right, so Lamania testing stone. Edit that page. Edit the release notes. Is there a category for those? I have an ADHD issue. All right, so I already added that to that. Where beta updates, okay. So let's go to beta updates. Epic Wand Bracelet. So I want to go to template name jewelry. And I want to copy and paste. I want to paste that in there. I want to grab the image name, which is Miss. Well, actually, we're going to go to that page. That's an incorrect description. It should actually be Epic Wand Bracelet.png. Based on the information in the image, well, there's no enhancements on it. So it is a Lamania version for sure. Min level 20. There are no race restrictions. We can dump that. It is a wrist item. It is bound to account, bound on acquire. Has a durability of 120. Has a material of leather. Has a hardness of 17. Cost is 12005. That's platinum. So PP. Its weight is 0.10. It is not an epic version of something else. I need to fix that sometime. There's no crafting description. So that belongs down in pick descript. Description is simply a special bracelet that can store wands and scrolls. It will take on the properties of an item you fuse with it and allow you to activate similar abilities daily. All right, so revise. Nope. This is based on something that was on Lamania, so. Good morning, Lyrical. Yes, lots of viewers. I actually, for like 30 minutes before the stream, I went on Kyber and Caneth, and I put up an LFM kind of advertising Quartervan stream of which I'm hosting. So, those things it doesn't say, Miss Sands. You'll see that the picture there is broken. Yes, I'm aware of this. That will be fixed at some point. It's going to be a huge update for me for that. So this is a incorrectly titled name. It should be Epic Wand Bracelet.png, simply. Renamed for compliance with file naming policy. So that's been moved as a redirect, which we're going to go here. I'm going to see if anything actually uses that. It doesn't, so I can say that's not going to show up. I can copy this URL. I can go on my ShoeMaker account to that page. I can delete that page. Page name typo. Delete page. You got it on Twitter. So that's done. Recent changes. Shrink that down. So this page should be gone now. You'll notice that if I click on read to make this page appear, the image will show up. Sometimes it doesn't. If it doesn't, you just have to use your bypass, Control R or Control Shift R or whatever it happens to be. So that's a Lamania thing. You'll see that it still shows up in pages with broken file links. That is just because it hasn't purged through the system yet. If I go to refresh, that should fix that. It didn't, so let's try manually adding it to the bar, purge. Still not fixed, so we go with the last fallback, which is you edit the page. When you get categories that get stuck and you hit edit and then save, you don't actually change a thing and then it goes away. It's called a null edit. It kind of forces it through the queue that way. So we had all these Lamania release notes and none of the other ones have Lamania on them. So let's fix that. We're going to go through and edit all of those pages. Ah. we're going to go at the very top of the page. We're going to go Lamania sort equals star, copy, paste. Next one, scroll down, edit, enter. We don't need the extra line, so just enter, paste, save, scroll, oopsie, paste, save, paste, paste, save, paste, paste, save, paste, paste, save. I might actually create a different template for this, for these at some point. But for now, we're just going to use what we got. All right, so that adds that to all of those. And if we scroll to the bottom, we got Lamania, and all of those are now listed under star, so they're easy to find there. Some of these should be gone through and checked and confirmed and have the Lamania tag removed. So let's go to recent changes. What do we got going on here? Yes, kitty. Yes. Ah, so we got two moves there. Couple deletions. Okay, so last edit by Titan was at 8:33. You'll notice this is 9:33. It's actually Central Time because of where DDOwiki is hosted from. So what I'm going to do now, yes, my cat wants the TP. Or actually, she wants the CF, the cat food. So I'm going to please her. It's 8:40 now. I usually take a 10-minute break at 9 o'clock. I'm going to take that 10-minute break 20 minutes early today. Refresh your coffee, go to the bathroom, grab a snack, and we will be back in 10 minutes. Do 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 do. Sipping my coffee. Do 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 do. I said 10 minutes. Do do do. I've got two more. Boo boo doo doo. All right, I won't torment you anymore. Coming back a couple minutes early here, but it looks like there was a lot of discussion while I was up feeding the cat. Let's see here. Good morning, Paladin Potato. Let's add you to the list here. Paladin P-O... T-A-T-O. Good morning, Ed. Anybody else that I'm missing this morning? Let's see here. Doesn't look like it. All right, so... Someone had one of those stones on live. Yeah. Watch here. You swing that sword. Too late. Excalibur picks. Wow. Look at all the viewers. Ba ba da ba. Nice, smart. Ah, okay. There we go. Feed me two-legger. That's basically what she was saying. Although it was more of a feed me daddy. Because of, you know. The Night Rebels page for the three rubies. Ghostbane, Vampire Slayer, and Endless Night. Example, cost one signet of Endless Night. Oh, okay. I see what you're saying. Fresh Roast, recent changes. Okay, so. Refresh recent changes. Before I get to the Night Rebels stuff... Stuffs. Epic Knight Blade. Okay. That's an item, right? Right, Titan? Alright, so. What you need to do. Well, what's this template Epic Knight Blade stuff? Huh? Huh? What's that? I'll let you work on it. You let me know if you get stuck in the next 45 minutes, and we'll fix it at the end of the stream, okay? Also, it needs to be in the item namespace, because it's an item. So, to move it, you're going to go to move. You're going to go here. You're going to scroll to the bottom. You're going to put it in item. I'm not going to hit the move page button. I'm going to let you do that. Make sure that you put it in, put a thing in there. I'll get to the three rubies, but before I do that... I don't like this headset. Alright, so there it is. Alright, so before I do that, Three Barrel Cove. Let's go back to the Three Barrel Cove thing. You're doing the Three Rubies thing? Okay. See, my old headset had the... mute microphone button on the bottom right here, and the new one has it in the front here, or the back. It's in the back, and I just have to get used to remembering that it's in the back on the side instead of on the bottom like my old set. That's going to take a little bit of adjustment for me, I guess. So you're doing that thing. Let's go back to Three Barrel Cove, way back at the beginning. I haven't forgotten. Let's see here. Which is good for me because I have a horrible memory. I am great at forgetting things. Let's see here. Somebody mentioned Three Barrel Cove. I sacrificed good sleep for this. It was worth it, Titan. We're up to 24 viewers. That's the highest I've ever seen it. Three Barrel Cove. Where was the Three Barrel Cove discussion? Three Barrel Cove map still shows the Minotaur as being a rare. So, Three Barrel Cove map. Is that heroic? What was his name? Scorch Tusk. Let's see if I can figure out where he is. Lacerator, Stranatati, Duke, Chortle. Scorch Tusk, okay. So, right down here, which you can't see because it's like right behind my Movember banner there. So it's like right down here, just below this. Or on the mini map, it's up here. Is he not a rare? Slay Scorch Tusk, Minotaur Bruiser. Orange name mini boss. Oh, he always spawns, doesn't he? He moved to the ship under the lighthouse area. If you can get a screenshot of that, where he is on the mini map, and you can upload it to the wiki, or you can send me an email and I will reply and you can email it to me. We can get that updated. Updating maps is a pain in the butt. That's why there's actually nobody doing maps right now. MJoel used to like to do it. He was a sick and twisted individual, I suppose. But it was very beneficial. If anybody wants to do maps, that would be great because we don't have anybody that does them right now. We just kind of like do screenshots of the minimap and call it good. Throw some stuff in there, and that's the best as it is. Nobody actually goes through and modifies things. I have a project in my head of where I would like to make the maps be layered SVG images, where you can toggle off on and off different layers, but that hasn't happened yet. It may even just be a series of ping images that I end up doing, and then using JavaScript, having them be able to be toggled on and off, transparencies, but that hasn't happened yet either. So if anybody wants to work on maps, that would be great. But yeah, I really can't do much about the map thing right now until I know exactly where he spawns now. Then we could probably figure out how to move him. But image editing can be a pain in the butt if you don't enjoy it, I suppose. So let's go back to recent changes. Epic Nightblade. You're still working on that, Titan? Or have you given up on that? He might have multiple spawn locations. He might spawn in one or the other. And we can update for that too. That would be a lot easier to update than to actually move him. So, Titan. Alright, so Titan, you should work on your Epic Nightblade. I'll take care of the rubies. Let's refresh recent changes. Ruby of Ghostbane. All right, so I'll pop that open. Page history. Done, huh? Almost. Except I'm going to undo that, because that is not correct. The correct answer is Joe Candy Maker. Knight Rebels Recipe. Chocolate 120. Almond 80, apple 80, caramel 80, cinnamon 80, show preview, make sure I got that right. I don't. Okay, so let's go to Knight Rebels recipe. And it's got to be ing in front of each of those. So, ing cinnamon, ing caramel, ing apple, almond, chocolate. Alright, so this is what we're going to do. And Joe Candy Maker works, that's good. Let's take a look at him real quick. The Knight Rebels Trader. Alright, so we are going to copy this. Save page. That's the correct way to do it. Named augments red. And we're going to do Endless Knight and Vampire Slayer as well. Edit. Edit. Scroll down. Found in. Paste. Scroll down, paste, updated. And that's how we make that look, Titan. All right, so this monk life, I've been getting this message a lot. Missed opportunity to cast special ability. Something around those lines. Why does that pop up? Unfortunately, I am not the right person to ask about monk effects and monk things. I've never ever played a monk past level 7. I honestly dislike playing monk. It's not something that I enjoy. It's a great class for those that enjoy it. I know that it's planned to get an update pass between update 30 and 32 sometime, which would be the first half of next year. That's the current plans for it, as far as I know. I can't say exactly which update, despite having a more refined idea in my head. But yeah, I don't play monks, so I really don't know. The page still says it's 20. I am guessing, without even looking at the page, that is because you have used the epic parameter. So let's take a look. Let's see if if epic is set to anything other than no. And what is this template epic Nightblade stuff? Come on now. Let's go fix that. All right, so we get rid of the things there. We don't need those. Epic, it's not the epic version of the Nightblade. No. Fix non-realistic template call and epic. Make that go away, and now it should show up as bin level 30. You still need to move this page. Why don't you go ahead and move that? And for if it's not something, the epic parameter that you had set to epic Nightblade or Nightblade is only used for things that use the old seal shard scroll upgrade system. It's not used for anything else, even if it's got the word epic in it. It's very confusing, and it is something that's going to go away in the future. It just hasn't gotten there yet. For upgradable, if it's none, then you leave it blank. You don't add anything to it. I'm going to let you work on that. You let me know if you need any help with it. Anybody else that is working on a page that needs help with it, let me know. During the stream is the best time for new people to go in and edit the wiki because they can get on the stream, get into chat, and say, "Hey, Shu, why isn't this working? What am I doing wrong?" And I can look at it right on the stream. You can see me, you can see what I'm doing, and I can show you how to fix it. So this is the best time to try to make edits and not have to worry about breaking things because I am right here to review and fix them for you as needed. So get in there and start editing. Yeah. All right. So let's see here. I gotta sip my coffee after that. I've expended a lot of energy getting excited about people editing. I get really excited when more people edit. That's awesome. Awesome coffee. When you're not at work, that would help. I'm actually debating adding another stream in, but I don't know how much DDOwiki people can handle. I am considering doing. Let me bring up this real quick. Ah! Well, I can't leave my picture there apparently. All right, let me make my picture go away. I am considering, let's see here. I do Tuesday morning. Tuesdays are kind of full. So I am considering starting to do, well, yep, Minion Monday afternoon. Good morning, Virtual Gib. See, Mondays work okay for me. Tuesdays are the best, but Tuesdays are full as far as I'm concerned. Thursdays, not so much. Fridays, not so much. Saturdays, no, because of other things. Because I go to church on Saturday, actually. I could probably do a Sunday. I don't know. I will have to look at my schedule and think about it. I'm thinking of adding another stream either on the weekend, on Sunday, or in the evening for me, just for time zone differences. Let's add virtual gib here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21 people. What's the first thing you do for a move? All right, so you're on the Epic Nightblade, right? You go to the page you want to move. That's the first thing you do. Then, from the page, you go to this little drop-down arrow thing right next to the star, which may or may not be blue. Right? So you go to the drop-down and you click on the link for move. Then you figure out where you want to move it to. So since you're changing namespaces from main to item, you go here and you select item from the drop-down. Epic Nightblade is correct. You type in move to item or move to proper NS item, right? And then the only thing you have to do is click on the move page button and it moves it. I'm gonna let you do it. And while you do that, I'm going to check recent changes here. Right, so not done yet. Let's pop into Mibit real quick into IRC. We are DDO stream. Let's see if we can get a few more people. Throw that up in there. Looks like everybody's asleep in there. No Titan. And DDOwiki is me, and me. Busy channel. All right, so slide that over there. Recent changes, let's refresh that. I don't stream to YouTube as well as Twitch. I'm not sure how to double stream yet, to dual stream, and I'm not sure that my XSplit will actually allow me to do it without purchasing it, paying for a license. So I'm just using the free version, which I believe only allows me to stream to one location at a time. Although I do upload the archives to YouTube when I'm done streaming, so you can find them there. If you go to the forums, yep, that's because you're not changing the namespace, Titan. You have to make sure that you click on this box right here and click on item. So, to new title, change main, and you're going to have to scroll down to item. Because you're changing namespaces. The item page name is the same, it's just the namespace that you're changing. So let's go to the forums here, let's log in. Let's go to subscribe threads. All right, so DDOwiki stream. So back to Virtual Gibbs YouTube comment. If you go to the forums and you look for the DDO stream, DDOwiki talk with T13 thread, and you subscribe to that thread, every week I update this list here to add the next episode. This will be episode 10. And then not only do I add it to the playlist at the top here, but I also embed each video 1 week at a time into the thread itself, so you can actually just go through and watch them all right on the forums. So, yeah, we can, you know, watch them right here. Isn't that exciting? You can watch me twice. Don't forget to check out Movember, my Movember page. Support Team Turbine and the DDO Wiki. And then you can see the URL to our playlist down here on the bottom. Yeah, we did a whole bunch of... So, there we go. Stop that. We don't need to watch that anymore. You can find it on the forums. YouTube. Move page. And it's going to yell at me. And it's going to say, that's already been moved. Do not have permission to move this page. And this is how Titan moved Epic Nightblade to Epic Nightblade. Haha. So, recent changes. Move log, yay! Why is Epic Nightblade blank? There's no reason to blank the page, Titan. Just to let you know. You can leave the redirect. It improves searchability. Nope, you can leave the redirect. There's no reason to blank it. Redirects are good. That way, if somebody types up here that they want Epic Nightblade, and they click on Epic Nightblade, it will take them through the redirect to Epic Nightblade. The only time that I delete or remove redirects is when the page name that it's being moved from is not a plausible search term. So for my file example that I moved, that was not a plausible search term. But if it's something that somebody could search for, then yeah, we leave the redirects. Redirects are good. Actually, I need to make a script sometime that will go through and get a list of all pages that are in item and make sure that there is a corresponding redirect in... main. Your internet connection is garbage. Mine's not that great either because I'm streaming through my wireless adapter instead of moving my router because I'm lazy. So yeah, recent changes. All right. So let's go back to Epic Nightblade. It looks like Titan has left some information out. So let's edit the page. Scroll down. All right, so if we scroll over here, we click in here. So we have cost is 33, 57, 5 gold, 0 silver, 0 platinum. We can do that because we can. It's got a hardness of 22. It's got a durability of 140. It's got a weight of 8 pounds. Uses a strength and strength. Damage profile is plus 4 slash magic by Shik. We don't, but that's why it has the Lamania template on it. It doesn't matter if they're different. When it goes live, if it's different, then people can change it and remove the Lamania template. So it's got Keen. It's got Material Bishik. That's the whole purpose of the Lamania template. It's got Augment Red and Augment Purple. All right, so let's do a show preview. Well, Keen says Keen 1, and I believe it's actually redirecting to a different template if we go to Keen. It's probably using damage. Use template damage instead. So it's going to be damage Keen. Shouldn't be dual boxing. It's against TOS. So let's go down to Keen. Keen's not there. Maybe it's at the bottom. Accuracy, alignment, bashing, combat, crit range, impact, and keen. All right, so that's how that works. All right, so show preview. There we go. That looks good. And notice the base value. 33,357 platinum pieces and 5 gold pieces. But we just typed it in as 33,57,500. It's a very smart template as far as that goes. That took a lot of work. Epic item page thingy, okay? So we fill in the blanks there. Why does it have plus 12 and hit? Enhancement bonus. Oh, because you use the regular Nightblade instead of the Epic. Is there an image for the Epic? There isn't one. Okay. Well, because that was the wrong image, we can go through and we can actually remove all of the other stuff. Because it's not accurate. That's 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 not accurate. And none of that's accurate. And that's blank, and that's blank. And even if it's wrong, it's fairly easy to fix. This has got to be a. Yep, but we don't know if it's going to be 29 or 30 or something else. Especially since it's Epic Tempest Spine, it might be something else. I'm going to make this a hidden category. It should exist, it should be hidden. All right, recent changes. Epic Joker, the Silver Tongue. You know, Titan, you can actually create the pages right in the item namespace and not have to move them. But that's okay. If you want to create them here and then move them, that's fine. Yep, that's the Choker of the Silver Tongue. Are you guessing that these will be what the items are based on what's in the heroic version? Because that would be a really, really bad assumption. And actually, that brings me on to another topic. This is not even, this isn't even Lamania stuff. This is speculation stuff. And that should be speculative. What was those other ones that you did too? This one, this one, this one. Nope, that one, that one, that one, that one. That can go away. So we gotta go through and Titan made a bunch of boo-boos without leaving a redirect. All right, so that was JJ's mistake. I'm gonna open that. We're gonna make that a redirect. Open that, make this a redirect. restart that. I did that backwards. It's okay. Edit and open that. Make this a redirect. Okay. So, Lamania is incorrect. Lamania is incorrect. We don't know that. We don't know that. See, isn't it wonderful that Titan made so many mistakes or assumptions? Because now you get to see what happens when you make mistakes. He didn't break anything. It's okay to make mistakes. And it's really easy for me or somebody else that's experienced to go in and fix those mistakes. That one's already marked as speculation. Speculation, speculation, speculation. Edit. And he's learning from the mistakes. Oh, somebody already updated it. I'm guessing Titan's going through with me and updating them. All right, so let's test on this one here. Any pages that need a move? Any that are not in... Excellent. Any that are not in item namespace. So check and see which ones are in the item namespace. And go ahead and move them. Some changes. You shouldn't post your email in live chat here, but that's okay. I don't usually send them by email. I usually send them by private message inside of Twitch. Oh, that reminds me. So these codes that I give out, right? How do you redeem them? I found last week that people were having difficulties with them. And people have been having difficulties with them, so I created a page for it. Yeah, I don't do whispers, Titan. I actually send PMs. So I created a page for how to redeem turbine point codes that you get from DDO Stream. First thing you do is you navigate to myaccount.turbine.com, which is going to load up there. All right, so you come to this page, right? That's myaccount.turbine.com. First thing you need to do is log into your account. It gives you instructions on that here. All right, so instructions for that are enter your username that you use to log into the game. I should fix that typo, but I haven't gotten to it yet. Enter your password that you use to log into the game. Enter the captcha anti-bot text from the image. You can see 110 there. Yours will be different. Step number four, click the login button. All right, so we have DDO Stream. We have our password, and we have a looks like a 418 there, and we log in. All right, so you'll see that nope, PMs still work. I sent one out last week. The only thing that they're doing away with is IRC, and it still kind of works, but it kind of doesn't. So once you get logged in, you should be at a page that looks like this, right? You're currently logged in as DDO Stream, activate product key, Dungeons and Dragons online subscriptions. You will see that even though I'm logged in, the bottom pane isn't showing up right now for me. I'm gonna click on the home and see if that fixes it. It doesn't. So at this point, I cannot enter a point code. Refresh the page. So I hit refresh a couple times. I did a control R to purge the cache of what was in my system, and now it's showing up. So the next step is once you're logged in and this box shows up, click on the link to add game time or points code right here. All right, so we're going to click on that and a little box shows up. This box right here is where you enter your code. That's where your code goes. That's probably not a valid code. I just typed in a series of random characters, but that's where you type in your code. Then you hit submit. So you type in your code in that box and hit submit. And it will take you to a page that looks like this. Subscription term, please review the terms and click submit. Subscription terms and conditions. All right, so you'll click on the view button. You'll use the scroll bars to scroll down in each section and read through the terms. Once you're done reading the terms, you'll click the little checkbox and click submit. You'll get come to a page that will say this key will grant 500 points. You will not be billed by Turbine. It'll bring up this box. Make sure that no, I don't want to subscribe now is selected. Unless you want to add, you know, add a subscription, a month, a year, 3 months, or 6 months. Apparently, they have that numerically sorted instead of chronologically sorted. I don't know. It's something that their web development team should fix, in my opinion, in order to look more professional. But, you know, they really don't have a web development team at this point. I'm thinking that Severlyn should put in for one. There's a lot of things on their web presence that could be updated and fixed. But, you know, Severlyn, you know, has his eyes set on another artist right now. He's not interested in a web development team at this point. It's something that could really use an overhaul. Really, really use an overhaul. So they just have to, you know, use the Turbine web development team, which is spread thin across 3 games. You know, whatever. Chrome is always acting weird, Titan. So moving on. Make sure that it's no unless you want to buy a subscription. Click on submit. Then you will wait. Actually, I don't need to blow those up. And you'll get a confirmation email. I use Gmail. It'll say it's from Turbine, my account at Turbine, product key receipt, hello DDO stream, this key will grant 500 points, blah blah blah. The actual receipt will show you this. And then you'll have your 500 Turbine points. But you got to make sure that you are putting your code in the box that shows up when you click on the add time or points code right there on the My Turbine page. Ah, Noble Pirate and Jibbo, Chatterbox. Not a lot of useful information there. All right, so let's see what do we got here. That's some rate recs, some speculation. Okay, so. What do we got here? Well, let's see if there's any pages that we missed that Titan created that were speculation. So let's look at Titan's contributions. He has made 72 edits. He's almost up to the point where he earns VIP, even though he got it a little bit early. Let's see here. Festival Solar. Let's take a look at that. Oil of Incandescence, Bottle of Fear, Draught of Midnight, Reveler's Regalia, The Fatal Flaw. Let's see here. Epic Elemental Mithril Breastplate. Okay, so Festival Solar is an enhancement. Enchantment, that's fine. Oil of Incandescence, this should be on an item page, and it is. It's going to be hard for you to see, but it says item right there, so we know that we're on the right namespace. That looks fine. I don't like the way that that image shows up. How is that done to make that show up like that? It's using consumable and it's just added to the end. Let's dump that and let's put that there. I'm going to add a little bit more spacing. Because I think it makes it easier to read the code. Show preview. Well, let's take a look at the source code for the consumable template. Yep, I'll get to recent changes in a moment. I'm working on cleaning up your edits at the moment. Although, yes, enable your cookies. That's a very good point. All right, so template consumable does not have a picture. It just has a pictoscript. Let's take a look at the code for it. See if there is one, it just isn't being used. Pictoscript. There isn't one. Okay. So what we're going to do is, since that doesn't exist, we are going to put it back the way that he had it, almost. We're going to put the file, that stuff back in there. Cut that out. Delete that. We're going to go to the end of description, or the beginning of description. I'm going to put that in at the beginning of description as a thumb image. Show preview. And that will make it look a little bit better. We're going to add a little bit more detail. Call it focus or view. How do you enable cookies in Chrome? All right. So in Chrome, click on the little thing over here, and you go to settings. And you go to show advanced settings. Cookies are on by default. I don't want to be tracked. Cookies. So up in the top of settings, you got the search settings. You can type in cookies. So content settings. Cookies. Allow local data to be set. Make sure that this is not checked. That's all of that. You don't need a clear. So there's cookie. So if you type in cookie and you click on content settings under privacy, you can actually clear that out even. And under privacy content settings, at the top, cookies allow local data to be set. And make sure this is not blocked. That's how you turn on cookies. Yes, they are usually enabled by default. All right, so elemental mithril breastplate, we're going to edit that one. The fatal flaw. Is that in? It's not in that category. I'm going to edit that one. This is Lamania. Somebody should go through and check and make sure that that is still accurate, being out of Lamania. That is an item namespace. The fatal flaw is an item namespace, but we're going to edit it anyway. We're going to go down to, we got a double description there. We need to get rid of one of those. In tips, we are going to go to help improve templates, and we are going to add in tips, add category needs, info box, pick and reason, non yellow icon version needed. And we're going to copy this, save that. This is already an item, that's good, except that this should be speculation instead of Lamania. Actually, since it's speculation, anything that you put in there is fine. That's fixed. The fatal flaw is in the right place and is now in the hidden category needs info box pick, because this is a yellow titled item. Drought of Midnight looks good. Game bugs. I'm curious as to what the game bugs are. Bottled Fear. That one should be in game bugs, so we're gonna edit that. Oil of Incandescence, we're done with that one. Titan Want Recent Changes. Thank you for your appreciation. There's a lot of things that the wiki needs to have updated and to have added and to have fixed, and it is a wiki, which means that it's a collaborative effort in order to make it work. And right now, we're over mostly recent, well, until really recently, we have been really, really short on active editors. Part of the reason that I started doing this stream on Twitch as a part of DDO stream was to increase the number of editors on the wiki. We need more people editing. Titan wanted me to see the edit that he made to Choker of the Silver Tongue. Yep, that's good, Titan. This part right here can actually stay, because I am pretty sure that that picture won't change. So that one's okay to keep. Actually, no, this is the regular Choker of the Silver Tongue, and that does exist. So I'm just going to roll you back. Is real world money involved with the wiki in any way or no? Define any way. Is it a paid service? Do editors get paid? No, not specifically. We do special events where you may win turbine points, which I suppose, like this stream that I'm doing here, where I give out 500 turbine points at the end, I guess you could associate that with real world money. There will be other prizes this year that may be worth real world money, and so there might be some for that. I know I'll be giving out turbine point codes. I don't know if anybody else is going to offer any specific rewards. I might offer rewards. I am thinking about there might be a lifetime VIP, maybe. I haven't confirmed that with Cordovan yet. So, real world money is a kind of vague term. Do you need to buy any special privileges for the wiki to edit stuff? No. Anybody can edit. Which page needs updates? If you type in C:pages, you'll see there's a pages in need of editing, pages need editing, pages need updating, pages where expansion depth is exceeded, template size is exceeded, using deprecated parameters and templates. There are lots of pages. Mostly, yes, up until super user. Once you get to super user, then it becomes an issue of contributing more. The more you contribute, the better off you'll be. But in order to get administrator, which is the next step above super user, you need to, there needs to be a discussion amongst the other editors and administrators to see if adminship is correct for you. But yeah, editing is free, and you can't really break things. If you make mistakes, like Titan is making tons of new editor mistakes, but that's fine. I encourage that. Make mistakes. Let me go through and fix them and teach you how to fix them. Mistakes are okay. What was I going to change here? Oh, I was going to mark this as a bug. Learn from mistakes. Mistakes are good, as long as you're learning from them. So there's a bug there. And adding that should add it to game bugs. Good. Drought of Midnight is in game bugs, but I don't know what the bug is. Bug warning. Okay, so the warning is a bug. I actually made that bug, and I didn't know what it was. Okay, so that's fine. Recent changes. Where are we at on time? Oh, we only got 5 minutes left on the stream. So we need to add Daniela. Good morning. And we are ready to roll. You're tired of learning. Need a dedicated screenshot person for all the missing pics, I would imagine. Yes, we need lots of dedicated people to take screenshots of all the pics that are missing. If you go to the homepage, I know, right, Titan? I lost track of time as well. If you go to the homepage and you start looking around, you will get to getting started right here. That gets you started in the game. And then you go down to About DDO, and you get to About, tells you about what we have here. Wanted pages, new pages. I might actually even get rid of that. Or change the links. I'm not sure that's appropriate for that. Community pages, administration. I'm going to be making modifications to that once I make some templates and some scripts. Licensing, everything submitted to DDOwiki is automatically licensed under Creative Commons Attribution Share Alike 2.5. We might actually have a discussion about that pretty soon. I think it's time to update that from 2.5. They're up to what, version 4 or 5 now? So we might want to look at the different revisions and update that. DDOwiki is not affiliated with Turbine Incorporated in any way. DDOwiki is completely run by the fans. Now, for what to do, there is this current projects thing, cleaning up and expanding the newbie guide, always on the list. Actually, let me go to this page and go to home, and we're going to zoom in a little bit. So you can see stuff, and I've got that there. I can make that shrink down. If we go down here, I zoomed in so much that you can't see that very well. I'm going to edit this current project section. Because I don't like the way that it's wrapping, I am going to move this up to the top, add your guild to the guild listing. No, we don't do that anymore. Add your characters to the character listing. No, we don't do that anymore at all. It's not something that's ever going to happen without major discussion. So we got expanding stubs. Fill in some wanted pages. Class guides need to be updated. Okay. Shuffle and remove things that should never happen without major discussion and change of consensus. Okay. Save page. Now, why did I change this? Make that go away. The reason I changed that is because I don't like the way that it wraps here because of the image. So if I refresh this page and I scroll down to that location, it still didn't refresh it for me. Purge. I did. There we go. Now they don't wrap as much because I moved them. I'm going to move this one up too, I think, because put the wrapping ones at the bottom. So you got, I'm going to update this and add some more stuff too. So if you want to look for things that need to be updated, this is where you go. Help and information wanted listing, pages needing information, missing images. Here you go. So item images that are missing things, creature images that are missing. Here's a huge list of creature images. Outdated or poor quality images. The fatal flaw one that I just added is there. So if you want to work on images, here is your Bible to work from. You can also work on our DDO information project, which is trap level stuff. Pages needing information. I don't think there's anything there. Oh, there is. So there's a whole bunch of things there that need work too. The snitch loot, basic armor, lots of stuff that need editing. Anyway, recent changes. It's 10 o'clock. Let's roll our prize. And our winner is Crazy Clown. Crazy Clown Crown, number 16. So, 2 days. I will show you that in a minute, Pub. 500 turbine point code winner is number 16, Crazy Clown Crown. You will receive a PM in Twitch by the end of the day today. All right. So we're done with that. So you want to know how many active editors we have. So if you go to special pages and you go to users and rights, we actually have a link for active users list. And on the active users list, which isn't currently sortable, I can change the list style. You can see that it shows 51 people that have been active in the last 30 days. Although a lot of those only have one edit. I haven't modified this to be sortable yet and to be able to filter out bots, but that's actually something I'm working on. So yeah, you can see how active people are and who's active. So it looks like I am in the lead for this month with 1,021 edits on my own account. And then as DDO stream, I got 388. Looks like the next most active person might be JJ with 495. And then Crew 121 with 309. And then 266 for DWiPi. And 204 for Cobalt Sneak, which is a bot account. These are sort of in alphabetical order. You can see Titan has 69 edits in the last 30 days. There are, how many articles are there right now? That's another question. This page is even 6 hours old. It's a cache version of the page. I wonder if I can purge it. I can purge it. So the most recent information is right there. We'll go down to Titan, and Titan still has 69. So bot accounts. There is one bot account that I'm aware of right now, and that is simply Cobalt Sneak. It's an account that administrators use to make repetitive edits for exactly the same thing multiple times in a row. There's two bots right now. Two accounts flagged as bot. Cobalt Sneak and MediaWiki Default. As part of bot, I need to update this page. It's treated as an automated process. It can delete pages, it can edit semi-protected pages, and it can use the right API like everybody else. That's actually not accurate. It can do more stuff. Bot accounts, you can see on the side over here, and that's not accurate. But if we go here, I need to update that page as well. We actually just changed a bunch of stuff. So you can bypass as any blocks. You can't block a bot. It isn't affected by auto blocks or IP blocks or range blocks. You have to block it directly. It can delete, it can duplicate, it is automatically marked as patrolled, it can patrol, it can have a patrolling bot. It is not affected by IP-based rate limits, not create redirects, it can suppress redirects, it can patrol, it can view deleted histories. I'm probably going to get rid of that. And it can add groups. I'm probably going to modify that as well. Although that's actually okay. You might, Titan, you'll be eligible. User list, contributions for Cobalt Sneak. Cobalt Sneak is like the third most active editor, 16,000 edits, but they're all bot edits. For example, usually it's things using AutoWikiBot. It does things like cleanup, replaces hit points with hit points, hit point, fix pluralization, setting up these pages as a work in progress. So all of these... It tagged all of these pages exactly the same as works in progress. Went through and updated template call, replaced some redirect category stuff. It's repetitive. They automatically correct pages. Yes, you tell them what changes you want to make, and they go through and they do a whole batch of pages with the same edit. Recent changes, and I believe that's the end of our stream. So, I will see everybody next week at the same shoe time on the same shoe channel. I hope you enjoyed episode 10. Congratulations to Crazy Clown Crown. And I will see you all next week. Have a great week, everyone.